So the tech savvy among you will already know that SSDs, or solid state drives, perform better than mechanical hard drives for everything from everyday use to professional applications. And the especially tech savvy among you will probably know that we've reached both a theoretical and real world performance limit for SSDs that connect to your PC using a SATA or serial ATA connection. With PCI Express SSDs, so drives that can connect directly to a controller on your CPU using a socket on the motherboard, emerging as the replacement. But what most of you probably haven't seen is any kind of practical, that is, real-world demonstration of the bottlenecks that exist in mechanical drives and in solid-state drives using SATA interfaces. Until now. This is our uncompressed video capture machine hooked up to a gaming PC. It uses a 4K capable HDMI capture device to obtain the best quality output from a video card or video camera. But that comes at a cost, with fairly short HD video clips taking up tens or even hundreds of gigabytes of space, like that. So I'm going to show you how well this works with a hard drive, how well it works with a SATA SSD like the HyperX Savage, and how well it works with a state-of-the-art PCIe SSD like the HyperX Predator. So we'll start with our hard drive. As you can see, the disk speed tool that Blackmagic provides is already telling us that this is straight up not going to work. But darn it, that won't keep us from trying. And it's gone. Our test bench fails to capture pretty much instantly. Next up is our HyperX Savage SSD. The disk speed test has an awful lot more checkboxes this time, but once again indicates that it's not going to work for 1080p at 60fps full color depth, etc. But if I didn't listen the first time, how likely is it that I'm gonna start listening now? And after a few seconds, it's done. Just like every other SATA-based SSD we've ever tried with this before. So finally, we get to our Predator PCIe SSD, rated at a whopping 1400 megabytes per second reads, and more importantly for this test, 1000 megabytes per second writes. The green checkboxes are all lit up, all systems are evidently go, and until we fill this drive up, there are no dropped frames to interrupt our recording. We have overcome the SATA bottleneck. Now, to be clear, running multiple SATA SSDs in RAID 0 can also overcome the SATA bottleneck, but it hurts reliability and on most motherboards doesn't really scale well past 2 to 3 SSDs, while with PCI Express, the sky is pretty much the limit. Please don't throw your SSD though, not that sky. Anyway, I think we're done here. Thanks for watching. I'm Linus. I'll see you again next time. That is assuming that you want there to be a next time, in which case you should probably hit like on the video and get subscribed so HyperX will bring me back for more of these spots.